We would like to share the story of a three-year CIHR-funded research project called Honoring Our Strengths, Indigenous Culture as Intervention in Addictions Treatment. This project was initiated by the National Native Addictions Partnership Foundation, the Center for Addiction and Mental Health, the Assembly of First Nations, and the University of Saskatchewan. Working with treatment centers of the National Native Alcohol and Drug Abuse Program and the Youth Solvent Abuse Program from across the country, our research team wanted to understand how culture was a support for client wellness and healing from addictions. Our goal was to design an assessment that would show the impact of culture on client wellness. This story shares how we did that and what we learned along the way. Our project started in 2012 with a meeting for all team members and collaborators. This is where the aims and goals of the project were established. An Indigenous knowledge group was also identified to guide the process and retain cultural continuity in the work we were doing. This group was comprised by elders, knowledge keepers, cultural practitioners, and Indigenous scholars. These team leaders oversaw each aspect of the project process and are present in each area of the work. We thank them once more here. From this meeting, the first stages of research began. Our team completed a scoping review that identified 19 relevant articles for our work in developing an assessment, and at the same time, we initiated an environmental scan with treatment center partners. This means that the project guiding elder Jim Dumont and researcher Laura Hall visited 12 treatment centers across the country for 3 days each, asking them to share about how culture was practiced at their center and how the centers understood the impact of culture on client wellness. One of the first things each center emphasized during these conversations was the importance of good food for wellness. To facilitate sharing this finding more broadly, each center contributed a recipe card that shares how food is foundational for healing and also how it can be an expression of culture that we engage every day. The 13 recipe cards, 12 from the treatment centers and one from our project team, also come with measuring spoons, and this is a way to share knowledge that has an immediate impact on the communities we serve. After the treatment center visits, our big team met again to hear what was shared and come to a common understanding of the knowledge that was offered. This was the meeting where Elder Jim Dumont put forward the Indigenous wellness framework and outcomes, based on the conversations with the treatment centers. This is the foundational framework for the project, for the assessment development, and most importantly, for wellness. He also shared a guiding definition of culture and a definition of wellness to help focus the research team's work. At this meeting, the treatment centers also shared their agreement with many cultural interventions identified as in common between them. With this information, our team began the long process of building the statements and scales that would become the Native Wellness Assessment. The Native Wellness Assessment consists of an administration manual, a self-report form for clients, and an observer rating form for service providers. Together, the two forms comprise a strengths-based, holistic assessment that focuses on the relationships in the client's life and reflects the impact of cultural programming on client wellness. When the Native Wellness Assessment was fully developed, we sent it out to many NNADAP and YSAP treatment centers for pilot testing with their clients. While the pilot testing happened at the centers, our academic team members worked from their skill set writing and publishing so that they could share the project process and encourage other research teams to work in similar ways. When the results of the pilot testing came back, they showed the Native Wellness Assessment is performing as expected. It is a culturally consistent and psychometrically valid assessment ready for application across the country. Health Canada is currently integrating the Native Wellness Assessment into the Addictions Management Information System. This database will make the Native Wellness Assessment available to all NNADAP and YSAP centers, along with community-based organizations and other initiatives for wellness across the country. Please contact the National Native Addictions Partnership Foundation for more information and to find out how you can access this important resource. But as you know, assessments and publications are not the whole story for growing wellness. We thought about the knowledge that so many contributed. We thought about the attention and the care. We thought about wellness and wanting it to grow. So our team developed the Growing Your Wellness Client Activity Guide and Facilitator Handbook. These materials introduce service providers and their clients to a step-by-step process that supports engagement with what Indigenous culture means for client wellness. This engagement is encouraged through growing a flower and makes culture as a support for wellness accessible to everyone. While this project is ending, we've only just planted a seed, and we need your support to keep it growing. Culture works. It is foundational for healing and for wellness. We hope you'll join the conversation.
Thanks. spirit is about belief, heart is about feeling, the mind is about knowing, and physical is about behavior. So that the question, the first question is, what did you believe before you heard the creation? What do you believe about yourself now? At the feeling levels, how did you feel about yourself before you heard this? How do you feel about yourself now that you have heard the creation? What do you know about yourself now? And then, how did you behave before? How does this change your behavior? And that work, I'm saying that work, because it involved the individual in a self-assessment that was meaningful. But it also extended the measure to all four levels.